Hello everyone, I am Dr. Meenakshi Rana, working as an academic consultant in the Department of Physics, Uttarakhand Open University, Haldwani. My video lecture presentation is on varector and photodiode. Here is the content of my video lecture. I will discuss introduction, working and application of varector and photodiode. Here is the learning outcome of this video lecture. After studying this video lecture, you should be able to define varector and photodiode, understand the working of varector and photodiode, and understand a number of applications of varector and photodiode.
Now we will discuss about the varector diode. What is a varector diode? The term varector diode is originated from a variable capacitor. Variable diode operates only in the reverse bias. The varector diode acts like a variable capacitor under reverse bias. Varector diode also sometimes referred as varicap diode, tuning diode, variable reactance diode, variable capacitance diode. They are manufactured in such a way that it shows better transition capacitance property than the ordinary diodes. The symbol of a varector diode is shown in the figure. The circuit symbol of the varector diode is almost similar to normal PN junction diode. Two parallel lines at the cathode side represent two conductive plates, and space between these two parallel lines represent dielectric. Now we will discuss how the varector diode works. Varector diode should always be operated in the reverse bias, because in reverse bias condition electric current does not flow. When a forward bias voltage is applied, the electric current flows through the diode. As a result, depletion region becomes negligible. We know that depletion region consists of stored charges, so stored charges becomes negligible, which is undesirable. Varector diode designed to store electric charge, not to conduct electric current. So varector diode always operated in reverse bias condition. When a reverse bias voltage is applied to electrons from N region and holes from P region move away from the junction, as a result, the width of the depletion region increases and the capacitance decreases. However, applied reverse bias voltage is very low, capacitance will be very large. Capacitance is inversely proportional to the width of the depletion region and directly proportional to the surface area of the P region and N region. So, the capacitance decreases as the width of the depletion region increases. So, if the reverse bias voltage is increased, width of the depletion region further increases and the capacitance further decreases. On the other hand, if reverse bias voltage is reduced, the width of the depletion region decreases and the capacitance increases. The decrease in capacitance means the decrease in storage charge. So, the reverse bias voltage should be kept at a minimum to achieve large storage charges. Thus, capacitance can be varied by varying the voltage. In fixed capacitors, capacitance will not be varied, but in variable capacitor, capacitance is varied. In a varector diode, the capacitance is varied when the voltage is varied. So, the variable diode is a variable capacitor. The capacitance of a varector diode is measured in picofarad, PF. Now, we'll discuss the application of varector diode. Varector diode have a number of applications. They are used in variable reactor in microwave circuits. It is also used in variable resonant tank LC circuit. It is also used in automatic frequency control, wherein varector diode is used to set the LO signal. Varector diode is used as a frequency modulator in radio and television sets. It is also used for a frequency multiplier in microwave receiver and as a RF phase shifter. It is also used in a voltage controlled oscillators. Now we will discuss about the photodiode. A photodiode is a PN junction semiconductor device that consumes light energy to generate electrical current. It also sometimes referred as a photo detector, photo sensor or light detector. Photodiode are specially designed to operate in reverse bias condition. Reverse bias condition means P side of the photodiode to the negative side of the supply and N side of the photodiode to the positive side of the supply. The symbol of the photodiode is similar to the normal PN junction diode, except that it contains an arrow striking the diode. The arrow striking the diode represents the light or photons. A photodiode has two terminals as cathode and anode as shown in the figure. Let us see how a photodiode works. A normal PN junction diode allows a small amount of electric current under reverse bias condition. To increase the electric current under reverse bias condition, we need to generate more minority carriers. The external reverse voltage applied to the PN junction diode will supply energy to the minority carriers but not increases the population of minority carriers. However, a small number of minority carriers are generated due to external reverse bias voltage. The minority carriers generated at N site or P site will recombine in the same material before they cross the junction. As a result, no electric current flows due to these charged carriers. To overcome this problem, we need to apply external energy directly to the depletion region to generate more charged carriers. A special type of diode is called photodiode is designed to generate more number of charge carriers in depletion region. In photodiode, we have used light or photon as the external energy to generate charge carriers in depletion region. Now, we will discuss the application of the photodiode. There are a various application of photodiodes. Photodiodes are used as a light sensor and smoke detector, compact disc player. They have also application as in space application. Photodiodes are also used in medical, such as in computed tomography, pulse oximeter, etc. Photodiodes are used for optical communication. They are used to measure extremely low intensity signals. I hope you have understood the varector diode and photodiode clearly. Thank you.